sold your number, sir. Thank you. A lot 663, then, ladies and gentlemen. A poster for this house's production of Hannibal by Salomo.
Showing here.
Do I have 10 francs? 5, then. 5, I am bid. 6, 7, against you, sir. 7, 8. 8 once. Selling twice. Sold to Raoul, Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you very much. Lot 664. A wooden pistol and 3 human skulls. From the 1831 production of Robert le Diable by Meyerbeer. 10 francs for this. 10, thank you. 10 still. 15, thank you. 15, I am bid. Going at 15. Your number, sir. Lot 665, ladies and gentlemen. A papier-mâché musical box in the shape of a barrel organ. Attached, the figure of a monkey in Persian robes playing the cymbals. This item discovered in the vaults of the theater. Still in working order, ladies and gentlemen.
Showing here.
May I commence at 20 francs? Oh, come, come, ladies and gentlemen. 15, then. 15, thank you. Yes, 20 from you, sir. Thank you very much.
25.
25 on my left. Thank you, madame. 25, I am bid. 30? Selling at 30 francs, then. 30 once. 30 twice. Sold for 30 francs to the Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you once again, sir.
Boy.
Collector's piece indeed. Every detail exactly as she said. She often spoke of you, my friend, your velvet lining and your figurine of lead. Will you still play when all the rest of us are dead?
Lot 666, then, ladies and gentlemen, a chandelier in pieces. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera, a mystery never fully explained. We are told, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the very chandelier which figures in the famous disaster. Our workshops have repaired it and wired parts of it for the new electric light, so we may get a hint of how it may look when reassembled. Perhaps we may frighten away the ghost of so many years ago with a little illumination, gentlemen!
See, Roma. It's a very hard for me, you
this
understand.
Way, gentlemen, this way. Rehearsals, as you see, are underway for a new production of Chalamet's Hannibal. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you may already perhaps have met Monsieur André and Monsieur Firmin.
I'm sorry, Monsieur Lefebvre, we are rehearsing. If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Monsieur. Proceed. Proceed.
Thank you, monsieur. Sad to return.
Monsieur, our chief repetiteur. It's rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Sad to return to find a land we love. To return once more by rums for reaching a grasp. Tomorrow ye shall break the chains of Roma. Tonight rejoice, your army hails a come home.
Signor Pianti, a principal tenor. Oh, he does play so well opposite La Calotta. Madame Giri, our ballet mistress. I don't mind confessing, Monsieur Firmin. I shan't be sorry to be rid of the whole blessed business.
I keep asking you, Monsieur, why exactly are you retiring?
We take particular pride here in the excellence of our ballets.
Who is that girl, Lefebvre?
Meg Giri, Madame Giri's daughter. A promising dancer, Monsieur André. Most promising.
You, Monsieur Daye, concentrate, girl. Monsieur, what's the matter?
Daye, curious name.
Swedish.
Any relation to the violinist?
His daughter, I believe. Always has her head in the clouds, I'm afraid. Now, gentlemen, if you come this way, I'd like to show you our next. Gentlemen, your attention, please. Ladies and gentlemen, Madame Giri, please. Thank you. May I have your attention, please? Now, as you know, for some weeks there have been rumors of my imminent retirement. I can now tell you that these were all true.
Oh.
And it is my pleasure to introduce you to the two gentlemen who now own the Opera Populaire, Monsieur Richard Firman and Monsieur Gilles André. Gentlemen, Signora Carlotta Giudicelli, our leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Of course, of course. I have experienced all your greatest roles, Signora.
Piacere.
Ahem.
And the Signor Ubaldo Piangi.
An honor, Signor.
Piacere. If I remember rightly, Elisa has rather a fine aria in Act 3 of Hannibal. I wonder, Signora, if, as a personal favor, you would oblige us with a private rendition? Unless, of course, Monsieur Rey objects.
My manager commands. Monsieur Rey?
My diva commands. Will 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars will be quite sufficient.
Signora.
Maestro.
Mademoiselle, please! What is going on here?
Are you all right?
Listen, no one concerned for prima donna.
Bouquet! Where is Bouquet? Get that man down here! Bouquet, chief of the flies, he's responsible for this! Bouquet, for God's sake, man, what's going on up there?
Please, monsieur, don't look at me. As God's my witness, I was not at my post. Please, monsieur, there's no one there, and if there is, well, then it must be a ghost!
Good heavens, I have never known such insolence!
Signora, please. These things do happen.
These things do happen? You have been here 5 minutes, what do you know? And did you stop them happening? No. And you're as bad as him. These things do happen. Well, until you stop these things happening, this thing does not happen. Ubaldo.
Si.
And Yomo.
Signora.
No.
Amateurs. I don't think there's much more I can do to assist you, gentlemen. Good luck. If you need me, I shall be in Frankfurt.
La Carlotta will be back.
You think so, monsieur? I have a message, sir. From the opera ghost.
God in heaven, you're all obsessed.
He merely welcomes you to his opera house, commands that you continue to leave box 5 empty for his use, and reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary?
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 20,000 francs a month. Perhaps you can afford more with the Vicomte de Chagny as your patron.
Madame, I had hoped to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte be at the performance this evening, monsieur?
Yes, in our box.
Madame, who is the understudy for the role?
There is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
Christine Daae could sing it, sir.
The chorus girl?
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher. I don't know, sir.
Oh, not you as well. Can you believe it? A full house and we have to cancel.
Let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well. Come, center. From the beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle.
This is doing nothing for my nerves, Andre.
Don't fret, girl.
But not so distant day, when you are far away and free. If you ever find a moment, spare a thought for me.
A disgrace. Such rondeaux, such tant de quiz. Come, we rehearse. Now.
Robin, Robin, Robin.
actions.
Don't be frightened.
Make sure. Are you a dancer? Well, then come and practice.
Always rehearsing more.
My dear, I was asked to give you this.
A red scarf. The attic. Little Lottie.
A tour de force. No other way to describe it.
What a relief and not a single refund.
Greedy.
Richard, I think we have made quite a discovery, Mr. Ayer.
Well, here we are, Monsieur le Vicomte.
Yes, gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
As you wish, Monsieur.
Thank you.
They appear to have met before.
Christine Daae, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur?
You can't have lost it. Not after all the trouble I took. I was just 14. Soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Oh, Raoul, so it is you.
Christine. Little Lottie, let her mind wander.
You remember that too?
Little Lottie thought, am I fonder of dolls or of goblins, of shoes?
Or of riddles, of rocks?
Picnics in the attic. Or of chocolates?
Father playing the violin.
As we read to each other dark stories of the North.
No, what I love best, Lottie said, sleep in my bed, and the angel of music sings songs in my head.
The angel of music sings songs in my head.
Father said, when I am in heaven, child, I will send the angel of music to you. Well, Father is dead, Ron, and I have been visited by the angel of music.
Oh, there's no doubt of that. But now we go to supper.
No, Raoul. The angel of music is very strict.
I shan't keep you up late. You must change. I must get my hat. 2 minutes. Little Lottie.
This slave of fashion, basking in your glory. Ignorant fool, this brave young suitor, sharing in my triumph.
Angel, I hear you speak, I listen, stay by my side, guide me.
Fluttering child, you shall know me. See why in shadow I hide. Look at your face in the mirror. I am there inside.
Angel!
serve me to sing for my music. My music. Night time sharpens, heightens each sensation. Darkness stirs and wakes imagination. Silently the senses abandon their defenses. Unfurls its splendor, grasp it, sense it, tremulous and tender. Turn your face away from the garish light of day, turn your thoughts away from cold and feeling light, and listen. Surrender to your darkest dreams. Purge your thoughts of the life you knew before. Close your eyes. Let your spirit start to soar. And you'll live as you've never lived. Softly, deftly, music shall caress you. Hear it, feel it, secretly possess you. Open up your mind, let your fantasies unwind in this dark. Darkness which you know you cannot fight. The darkness of the music of the night. Let your mind start a journey through this strange new world. Be the thoughts of the world you knew before. Let your soul.
see? Curse you! You little lime Delilah! You little vixen! Now you cannot ever be free! Damn you! Curse you!
To look or bear to think of me, this loathsome gargoyle who burns in hell but secretly yearns for heaven, secretly, secretly, but to see, to find the man behind the monster, this repulsive carcass who seems a beast but secretly dreams of beauty. Secretly, secretly. Oh, Christine.
Come, we must return. Those two fools who run my theater will be missing you.
Like yellow parchment is his skin. A great black hole serves as the nose which never grew. You must be always on your guard, or he will catch you with his magical lasso.
Those who speak of what they know find too late that prudence silence is wise. Joseph Bouquet, hold your tongue. He will burn you with the heat of his eyes.
Mystery of the gala night, it says mystery of soprano's flight. Mystified, baffled surety, say, we are mystified, we suspect foul play. Bad news on soprano scene, first Carlotta, now Christine. Still, at least the seats get sold. Gossip's worth its weight in gold. Diva Teller's resignation, covered as a moonlight flit. Half your cast disappears, but the crowd still cheers. Opera, to hell with look and handle, have a scandal and you're sure to have it.
Damnable, for they all walk out, this is damnable.
Andre, please don't shout, it's publicity, and the take is vast, free publicity.
But we have no cast.
But Andre, have you seen the cue? Oh, it seems you've got one too.
Andre, what a charming gala. Christine enjoyed a great success. We were hardly bereft when Carlotta left. Otherwise, the chorus was entrancing, but the dancing was a lamentable mess.
Dear Femme, just a brief reminder. My salary has not been paid. Send the care of the ghost by return of post. PTO. No one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed.
Who would have the gall to send this? Someone with a puerile brain. These are both signed OG.
Who the hell is he?
Opera Ghost. It's really not amusing. He's abusing our position. In addition, he wants money.
He's a funny sort of spectre to expect a large retainer. Nothing plainer. He is clearly
quite Where is she? I mean, Miss Di, where is she?
Well, how should we know?
I want an answer. I take it that you sent me this note.
What's all this nonsense?
Of course not.
Don't look at us.
She's not with you then.
Of course not.
We're in the dark.
You don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote? And what is it that we're meant to have wrote? Written? Do not fear for Miss Di. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again.
Well, if you didn't write it, then who did?
Where is he?
Ah, welcome back.
Your precious Peter, where is he?
What is it now?
I have your letter, a letter which I rather resent.
And did you send it?
Of course not.
As if he would.
You didn't send it.
Of course not.
What's going on?
You dare to tell me that this is not the letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days at the Opera Populaire are numbered. Christine Daae will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune should you attempt to take her place.
Far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Daae's name.
Miss Daae has returned.
In which case, I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home.
She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she sing? Will she sing?
Here, I have a note.
Let me see it!
Please! Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Daae has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress.
Disaster beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine.
Christine!
Whatever next?
It's full of blood to help Christine!
This is insane!
I know who sent this, the begone beloved!
Indeed, can you believe
Signora.
This?
Signora!
You are a star!
And always will be!
Signora!
The man is mad!
We don't take orders!
Miss Daae will be playing the page boy. The silent role.
Carlotta will be playing the lead.
You don't deserve her.
Is Ruth is trying for me.
Thank you.
Your public needs you.
We need you too.
Would you not rather have your precious little Eugène?
Signora, no. The world wants you.
Prima donna, first lady of the stage, your devotees are on their knees to implore you. Can you bow out when they're shouting your name? Think of how they all adore you. Prima donna, enchant us once again. Think of your muse and of the cues round the theatre. Can you deny us the triumph in store? Sing a prima.
Gentlemen, if you would care to take your seats, I shall be sitting in box 5.
Do you really think that's wise, monsieur?
My dear André, there would appear to be no seats available other than box 5.
His lordship sure would die of shock.
His lordship is a laughing stock.
Could he suspect her? God protect her.
Shame, shame, shame.
This famous lady's bound for ladies.
Shame, shame, shame.
Nothing like the old operas.
The old scenery.
The old singers.
The old audience.
And every seat sold.
Your disguise is perfect.
Hardly a disaster beyond imagination.
Why? Who can this be?
Gentle wife, admit your loving
loving husband. My love, I am called to England on affairs of state and must leave you with your new maid.
Whoa! Though I'd gladly take the maid with me.
The old fool's leaving.
I suspect my young bride is untrue to me. I shall not leave, but shall hide over there to observe. Adieu.
That box 5 was to be kept empty.
Is there the phantom of the opera?
Oh, it's him. I know it, it's him.
Christine.
Your part is a silent little toad.
A toad, madam. Perhaps it is you who are the toad.
Maestro, da capo per favore. Serafimo, away with this pretense. You cannot speak, but kiss me in my husband's
Behold, she is singing to bring down a chandelier!
Gentlemen, we apologize. This evening's performance will continue in 10 minutes' time, when the role of the Countess will be sung by Miss Christine Dyer.
Raoul!
Don't worry, I'm here.
In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we shall be giving you the ballet from Act 3 of tonight's opera. Maestro, bring the ballet forward. The ballet, now!
Thank you.
Nothing more.
Yet in his eyes, all the sadness of the world, those pleading eyes that both threaten and adore.
Darkness, forget these wide-eyed fears. I'm here, nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here with you, beside you, to guide. guard you and to guide you. Soon you'll be beside me.
You'll guard me and you'll guide me.
I gave you. Betrayed me. He was bound to love you when he heard you sing. Christine. Thank you.
Dear Andre, what a splendid party.
The prologue to a bright new year.
Quite a night, I'm impressed.
Well, one does one's best.
Here's to us,
the toast of all the city.
Such a pity that the Phantom can't be here.
Speeding lights,
masquerades. You can fool any friends whoever knew you. Masquerades!
Makes you proud, all the creme de la creme.
Watching us
and all our peers are in the
past.
Oh, baby!
Of delight!
Of Elysian peace.
And we can breathe at last.
No more ghosts.
Here's a help.
Here's a toast to a prosperous year.
To the new chandelier.
Six months.
What a blessed release.
What a masquerade.
Think of it. A secret engagement. Look, your future bride. Just think of it.
But why is it secret? What have we to hide?
You promised me
your
wealth is dirty.
Then let them see it's an engagement, not a crime. Christine, what are you afraid of?
Let's not argue. Please breathe.
I can only
in.
Hope
with
understanding
good. Have you missed me, good Monsieur? I have written you an opera. Here I bring the finished score, Don Juan triumphant. Advise you to comply. My instructions should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
Ha 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 ha!
not true. You've seen something, haven't you?
I don't know what I've seen. Please, don't ask me, monsieur.
Madame Giry, for all our sakes.
Very well. It was years ago. There was a travelling fair in the city. Tumblers, conjurers, human oddities.
Go on.
And there was. I shall never forget him. A man locked in a cage.
In a cage?
Oh, a prodigy, monsieur. A scholar. Architect. Musician.
A composer.
And an inventor too, monsieur. They boasted he had once built for the Shah of Persia a maze of mirrors.
Who was this man?
A freak of nature, more monster than man.
Deformed?
From birth, it seemed.
Oh, God, Christine.
Then he went missing. He escaped.
Go on.
They never found him. It was said he had died.
But he didn't die, did he?
The world forgot him, but I never can. For in this darkness,
so
I have
phantoms
seen him
again.
I have said too much, monsieur.
No, wait.
Too much. And there have been too many accidents.
Accidents? Madame Giry!
Ludicrous, have you seen the score?
Simply ludicrous.
It's a final straw.
This is lunacy, well you know my
utter lunacy.
But we daren't refuse.
Not another chandelier.
Look, my friend, what we have here.
Dear Andre Rimet orchestrations, we need another first bassoon. Every note's overblown, and the third trombone has to go. The man could not be deaf, so he's preferably one who plays in tune.
Dear firma vis-a-vis my opera, some chorus members must be sacked. If you could find out which has a sense of pitch, wisely though, I'd manage to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot act. What is it now? Signora, please.
Now what's the matter?
Have you seen the size of my bar?
Signora, listen.
It's impeachment.
Not you as well.
Just look at this, it's impeachment.
Please understand. Signora,
the things I have to do for my art.
If you can call this gibberish art.
Ah, here's our little flower.
Ah, Miss Dyer, quite the lady of the hour. You have secured the largest role in this Don Juan.
Come, Christine Dyer, she doesn't have the voice.
Signora, please.
Then I take it you're agreeing.
She's behind
it
this.
It appears we have no choice.
She's the one behind this, Christine Dyer.
How dare you?
I'm not a fool, you evil woman. How dare you? You think I'm lying?
This isn't my fault. I don't put any part in this plot.
Miss Dyer, surely. But why not?
What does she say?
It's your decision, but why not?
She's backing out.
You have a duty.
I cannot sing it, duty or not.
Christine, Christine, you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur, another note. Fondest greetings to you all. A few instructions just before rehearsal start.
Carlotta must be taught to act, not a normal trick of strutting. And my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts. As for Miss Christine Dyer, no doubt she'll do her best. It's true, her voice is good. She knows, though, should she wish to. She has much still to learn, if pride will let her return to me, her teacher, her teacher. Your obedient friend.
And angel. I can't. I won't do it.
We have all been blind. And yet the answer is staring us in the face. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend. We're listening. Go on.
we shall play his game, perform his work, but remember we hold the ace. For if Miss Dye sings, he is certain to attend.
We make certain the doors are barred.
We make certain our men are there.
We make certain they're armed.
The curtain falls. His reign will end.
I'm not so sure.
Not if it works.
This is madness.
The tide will turn.
Monsieur, believe me, there is no way of turning the tide.
You stick to ballet.
Then help us.
Monsieur, I can't.
Instead of warning us, help us.
I wish I could.
Don't make excuses.
Or could it be that you're on his side?
She's his accomplice.
Monsieur, believe me, I intend no ill. But, monsieur, be careful. We have seen.
We'll take the fall and folly will.
She's the one behind this curtain.
And this is the curse
of the curtain.
This is his only will. You sing sail on. We are sing this song of my curse.
Yourself, he was nothing but a man. Yet while he lives, he will haunt us till we're dead.
Twisted every way, what answer can I give? Am I to risk my life to win the chance to live? Can I betray the man who once inspired my voice? Do I become his prey? Do I have any choice? He kills without a thought. He murders all that's good. I know I can't refuse, and yet I wish I could. Oh God, if I agree, what horrors wait for me in this? The Phantom's Opera.
Christine, Christine, don't think that I don't care. But every hope and every prayer rests on you now.
Rest, please. Don Juan. Signor Piangi. See, here is the phrase. Those who tangle with Don Juan, if you please.
Those who tangle with Don Juan.
No! Nearly. But no. Those who tan, tan, tan.
Those who tangle with Don Juan.
This way is better. At least I make it sound like a music.
Signora, would you speak that way in the presence of the composer?
The composer is not here. And if he were here, I would...
Are you certain of that, Signora?
So, once again then, if you please, Signor. After 7. 5, 6, 7.
A doll's a hot tangolo with a donor.
Hey, you're not back! What does it matter what doll we see? No one will know if it is right or wrong. No one will care if it is right or wrong.
Promised her that he would send her the angel of music. Her father promised her. Her father promised her.
Thank you.
See, monsieur, how far you dare go.
More deception, more violence.
That's right, keep walking this way.
You can't win her love by making her your prisoner.
Please, I'm here, monsieur, the angel of death. Come on, don't stop.
No.
Don't go. So be it. Now let it be war upon you both.
You understand your instructions?
Sir!
When you hear the whistle, take up your positions. I shall then instruct you to secure the doors. It is essential that all doors are properly secure.
Are we doing the right thing, André?
Do you have a better idea?
Monsieur le Vicomte, am I to give the order?
Give the order. You, in the pit, do you have a clear view of this box?
Yes, sir.
Remember, when the time comes, shoot. Only if you have to, but shoot to kill.
How will I know, sir?
You'll know.
Monsieur le Vicomte, are you confident this will work? Will Miss Daae sing?
Yes, don't worry, fair man. André.
We're in your hands, sir.
My men are now in position, sir.
Go ahead, then.
Are the doors secure?
I'm here, the Phantom of the Opera. I'm here, the Phantom of the Opera. I'm here. I'm here. I'm here!
Fool! I said only when the time comes.
But Monsieur le Vicomte...
No buts. For once, Monsieur le Vicomte is right. Seal my fate tonight. I hate to have to cut the fun short, but the joke's wearing thin. Let the audience in. Let my opera begin.
Marina, faithful friend, once again reside the plan. For youngest beneath, I'm you, I the master, you the man. When you met, you wore my cloak, she could not have seen your face. She believes she dined with the you in your master's borrowed place. But if we will squawk and quaff, stealing what in truth is a mine, when it's late and the modesty starts to mellow with no wine, I come home, I use your voice, slam the door like crack of doom. I shall cry, come a hide with me, where aware of a curse of my room. For he hasn't got a chance. Here's the hat, my cloak and sword, conquest is assured. If I do not forget myself and the love. And the
laugh. Not within your heart, but dreams of love.
Master Passerino, go away, for the trap is set and waits for its prey. You have come here in pursuit of your deepest urge, in pursuit of that wish which till now has been silent, silent. I have brought you that our passions may fuse and merge. In your mind you've already succumbed to me, dropped all defenses complete. Succumb to me. Now you are here with me. No second thoughts. You decided. Decided. Past the point of no return. No backward glances, how games of make-believe are at an end. Past all thought of if or when, no use resisting, abandon thought and let the dream descend. What raging fire shall flood the soul? What rich desire unlocks its door? What sweet seduction lies before us? Past the point of no return, the final threshold, what warm unspoken secrets will
where speech
my solitude. Say you want me with you here beside you.
Across the lake, monsieur. This is as far as I dare go.
Madame Giry. Thank you.
At last in your lust for blood. Am I now to be prey to your lust for flesh?
That fate which condemns me to wallow in blood has also denied me the joys of the flesh. This face, affection which poisons our love. This face which earned a mother's fear and loathing, a mask, my first unfeeling scrap of clothing. Pity comes too late. Turn around and face your fate, an eternity of this before your eyes.
These haunted fates hold no horror for me now. It's in your soul that the true distortion lies.
Wait. I think, my dear, we have a guest!
Christine!
No!
Sir, this is indeed
an unparalleled delight. I had rather hoped that you would come! And now my wish comes true. You have truly made my night.
Free her, do what you like, only free her. Have you no pity?
Your lover makes a passionate plea.
It's right,
I love her. Does that mean nothing? I love her. Show some compassion.
The world shall know compassion to me.
Christine, Christine, let me see her.
Be my guest, sir. That I would harm her. Why should I make her pay for the sins which are yours? Warriors, I'm horses now. Raise up your hand to the level of your eyes. Nothing can save you now, except perhaps Christine. Start anew. Make your choice.
Thank you.
forget me, forget all of this. Leave me alone. Forget all you've seen. Go now. Don't let them find you. Just take the boat. Swear to me never to tell the secret you know of this angel in hell. Go.
Masquerade, paper faces on parade, masquerade, hide your face so the world will never find you.
Thank you.
Thank you.